Bathroom notes. They are the window to people's minds and boredom. We are exposed to these literary works every time we use the bathroom. But what a lot of people don't realise is that this growing trend is actually the start of a new crime rate. I'm Grant Turner of the BBC, and this is the journey into the minds of a bathroom vandal. Meet 21-year-old Fernandez Gomez. He has become a celebrity through bathroom notes.
I started writing bathroom notes when I was like 10 years old.
I heard a story that you were approached by an agent.
He approached me and said, "Would you like to make a lot of money? People will see me on the streets and be like, 'Oh, hello Fernando, hello.'"
In the bathroom, we are releasing.
What would your average bathroom note look like?
We will start with a piece of paper, and then I will begin with a letter.
It is poetry because it just comes to me while I'm chugging a shit.
You vent on these bathroom walls, but technically you're vandalizing.
It is not vandalizing if it is art. I am not doing it out of rebellion. I'm doing it out of passion.
So let's get back to this girlfriend that dumped you. How did you feel at that stage before you wrote this note?
I really love her.
Isn't it ironic that you're feeling sick at the toilet?
People gather around and watch me as I write these emotional, heartfelt letters.
So you're saying there's actually witnesses to your vandalism?
No.
You realise you're a vandal?
Get your
vandal! Must be Max Caddy, Fernandez's photographer. You don't actually like your job.
I do love my job. It's just that I don't like when I get jobs from, you know, Fernandez.
The fact that he got famous through bathroom notes is a bit absurd.
I think it's a bit weird.
When you first met him, what did you actually think of him?
Seemed like a nice guy, but as soon as he opened his mouth, I knew where it's been. It was pretty much all over his face, literally.
Meet Ari Jean, super agent to the stars. He represents Fernandez Gomez. He is nothing but a fraud.
Actually, your only client is for Fernandez.
Well, human client, vandal or artist? Our phone's ringing, hang on a second. Don't need the iPhone.
In that case, you actually don't afford the iPhone.
I can afford it, it's just...
But how can you afford the iPhone if your only client is Fernandez?
He's making big money. Look, this new jacket. Look at my new car. It's a beautiful car. He's making a lot of money for me.
I believe that's an early 90s laser. Future for Fernandez.
Movies. But we've already got, I'm heading over to Los Angeles around Hollywood. I've got him on Leno, hopefully. Letterman. I'm talking the big shows.
We actually looked up a bit of your company and it doesn't exist.
It does exist.
What's it called then?
Dentronicbusiness.au.
That doesn't sound real. Now, I can just safely tell you that you are now an accomplice in vandalising bathroom walls. Is this true?
It's not vandalism for the last bloody time. It's art. Art is what you see everywhere. Everywhere is art. It's a part of culture. Have you never seen culture before?
So are you saying that you're now confessing?
Go away. Go. I'm not going to confess anything. Talk to my agent.
But you are your own agent. You are your own agent. Come back here.
Later that day, we actually found Ari Jean working in a coffee shop. Turns out that he doesn't actually know Fernandez. When we did manage to have a chat to him, he tried to run away. Meet Becky and Jasmine, a lesbian couple who met through bathroom notes.
And I drew a picture of Marilyn Monroe having a good time.
Quite a popular icon there, yeah.
Yeah, that's right. The most popular blonde icon I can think of.
Mm-hmm. I was immediately drawn to her artistic creativity. Got to know each other on the bathroom wall.
Yes, it's very sweet.
We ended up with a phone number, and then we caught up afterwards.
But do you guys realise that you actually vandalise a bathroom stall? Do you guys actually care?
We all did it for love, so I don't think it matters too much.
There are much more absurd things than writing on a bathroom stall. I mean, we're not writing obscene messages.
In the name of love, after all. The vandalism doesn't matter that much.
It's just like meeting someone on the internet, but safer because you know it's a girl.
You guys do realise that you are now culprits. That you are the ones that are the criminals.
You're accusing us of being criminals?
Well, I do work for the BBC.
We thought it was in the name of love.
You girls just have to confess. All you girls have to do is confess.
Leave us alone, okay?
You girls have to just confess.
We thought this was in the name of love.
Everyone is going to see this. You didn't realise that. You girls will be found.
To a private investigator named Vin Diesel. But don't mix him up with a Hollywood star. He may look like him, but he sure doesn't act like him.
Yeah, they think it's all funny, they think all fun and games when they ride all over the walls and stuff, but the reality of the matter is, when I sit down to take a crap in a public toilet, I don't want to see that stuff, and I'm here to get rid of it. I've actually tried a few of those numbers, and it worked once. One time it fell through and...
Did you get any leads from there?
I didn't get leads, but I did get herpes.
Have you had any leads so far into this investigation? Have you caught anyone in the process of writing a bathroom note?
We've come close a few times, I'm sure of it. But they're pretty sly. They like to throw their permanent markers into the toilet and flush them away.
What's the one feature that you could tell that he or she is going to write on a bathroom wall?
Monobrow is a dead giveaway. 9 out of 10 people with monobrows go on to a long lifetime of vandalizing.
What do you think is going through these people's mind when they are vandalizing?
The thrill of doing something illegal.
I'm sorry, are you rolling a joint?
Tobacco, man. It's tobacco. It's the reason I got kicked off the force, to be honest.
That you're addicted to marijuana. If I was to grab your joint right now and chuck it out the window, what would you do?
I'd probably kill you. Honestly, I prefer it over the inspector job I had with the government. People think I just go to these strip shows and whatnot just to have a little perv and all that, but it actually does serve a purpose. They do give me some valuable leads a lot of the time. You'll go a whole night without saying anything. Again, that's usually because you've fallen asleep or something. I actually have been told that he's wearing dark blue jeans, a grey shirt, skinny bloke apparently.
Do you think you'll be able to catch all the people in the world who are bathroom vandals?
Honestly, I haven't caught one yet. Eventually, I'll get them.
A tip off that there is a culprit writing a note on the bathroom when a girl burst in a car affair style and grab him at his best.
Writer, BBC! Writer, what are you doing?
We'll get that boss. We'll get him. He'll be back.